With the final decision taken to run the Halo in 2018 as late as July, it meant that there was a huge amount of work, not just for Mercedes, but for the entire Formula One sport to do in order to be ready for the start of the new season. There was a lot of regulatory detail that needed clearing up, all the dotting of I's and crossing of T's necessary so that we would have both technical regulations and sporting regulations that would permit its use. But back here in Brackley, adopting it has been a significant challenge. This is not a light piece of work. It's several kilograms of titanium. Several kilograms of titanium that need to be put on the car, and all the changes that we needed to do to accommodate it made so that the overall car would still stay below the weight limit. And this is also not light because it takes really, really high loads. We had to strengthen the design of the chassis so that it would be able to take roughly the weight of a London double-decker bus sitting on top of this Halo to make sure that it would be strong enough to withstand the type of event that are designed to protect the driver's head against. In addition to the challenges posed by the Halo for the mass of the car and the loads that it subjects the chassis to, there is also a substantial aerodynamic challenge. The basic Halo is a standard part, identical for all teams. And this unadorned round tube is quite bad aerodynamically. So we're all permitted to modify the Halo in a way that will be individual for each team, because we're permitted to fit an aerodynamic fairing around it, which gives us a certain amount of scope to mitigate the effect that it has on the aerodynamics of the car. And what we're aiming to do there is ensure that the wake of this Halo does not affect the smooth running and powerful performance of the engine. So we make sure that the wake of the Halo does not get ingested by the engine. And we also make sure that it's designed such that it doesn't damage the behavior of the rear wing. The Halo is just the latest in a long stream of innovations to make sure that the head of the driver is well protected in the car. We've got helmets, of course, but also the hands device, the headrest, the cockpit sides. All these things aimed at keeping the driver safe in the car. But this is the first generation of head protection that goes up and over and around the driver's head. It's the first generation, but it won't be the last. Nothing in Formula One stands still for long. And we will all be taking this first go and trying to improve it, trying to make sure that the safety gets better, but also the aesthetics. It's a bit of an acquired taste, and we're still busy acquiring it, and I'm sure everyone else is too. But I think there's things we can do in coming seasons to make it also look nicer on the car. But there's no doubt that the imperative to look after the driver's safety and our clear desire to give us cars that are going to set the pulse racing aesthetically will see us continue to develop this concept in the seasons to come.